Today in Planet Coaster, we begin detailing the middle section of the Pharos of Alexandria, and I will probably ramble on about something that interests me. So let's get started. So I said in the previous video that it would be all about block building and everything, like just bare foundations, but I just couldn't resist putting like the roof building and the detailing of the first or the upper part into that video. So I kind of lied and let's forget that that's, well, not forget that it's there, because I'm still very proud of that roof, but let's just see that as like a little gift. But for this video, it is only going to be the middle part, or the, I still haven't figured out the name of the shape yet, because it's not round, it's not a cube, it's in between there, which in a way is like the perfect middle part for the Pharos, because you have the blocky base and then the complete round light part, which again I still don't know the name of the shape of the middle part, but it's something. But I do think that the upper and middle part are like the most Greek parts of the Pharos, and that the base, as I think I said in the previous video, is, I wanted to say Greek again, but the base is Egyptian and the rest is more Greek inspired, especially the top, because, well, there are all these Greek or Grecian pillars. There is a little bit of what's the name of it, it's not a fresco, because a fresco is flat and a bit like a mosaic, but it's just roof decorations, or that you also have on Greek temples. You have that in the Pharos as well, or at least in some pictures, because those pictures don't seem to have a clear idea on what it actually looks like, because again, it lies in ruins in the Alexandria harbor right now, I think. I don't know, actually. I should probably look those things up before I say them. But then I begin these commentaries always as like a mindless scroll, so it fits with, I wanted to say my brand, but it just fits with my personality to not look things up. In the end, I will look them always up. Like, I don't want to be a completely headless squirrel, but yeah. For a commentary, it's just more fun to start recording and just see where it goes. But to go back into what I was talking about, because this took a weird turn, but every picture of the Pharos is just completely different. There's, well, not completely different, they are universal on like the general shape of the, well, actually also not that, because I have seen other pictures of mostly, I think, medieval / Renaissance era pictures of the Pharos, and those things just look weird. They look like it's more of a cake than an actual building, because it's completely round, it's brown, when every evidence states that it was white or in some really light color. But then, yeah, Renaissance pictures or depictions of like Greek things sometimes are a little bit weird, looking back on it from now, when we do have like the clear research on how the things looked. And it's, yeah. Like, for a time that was so heavily focused on Grecian and Roman buildings, architecture, and just the time surrounding that, and the art and everything from that time, they didn't get some things really good. Some things is just like, all right. No, that's clearly wrong, but hey, that's hindsight. Like, they were probably like so enthusiastic that they just wanted to know everything, but then in that enthusiasm just overlooked things or tried to implement their own way of thinking into what actually happened. But back on the lighthouse, because I started talking about the building and then I went to Renaissance art depictions of the Pharos, and that's a weird turn to make, but all right. So there is a little bit of artwork, but then the Pharos doesn't really have a roof on like the middle or lower part, but it does have, I would say, balcony, and there is some like decoration on that. And here all sources are just like, yeah, no, this, this, that, this. So I kind of mixed two things up to make the balcony. Yeah, I'm not really talking about the middle part that I don't know the name of, or don't know the name of the shape of that thing. Because that part is just mostly pillars and a door. But I did a little bit more of decoration on that part because it just otherwise wouldn't really fit with the rest of the Annapolis to have this very bare structure, which is still an icon because it's huge, but it's very bare. So I had to make some artistic license and just have it a little bit more into Theonopolis style, which is a little bit more, I wouldn't say extravagant, but probably a bit more just colorful. Because over time, of course, buildings just get whitewashed. This is not some, you know, whitewashed as in bad thing, but it's just buildings just turn white over time. So there's a little bit more decoration here. It's a little bit more colorful. So I just kind of got like, all right, how would this look? How would this might have looked when it was finished and not when it was destroyed or when it was old. So that's why it's a little bit more colorful, because I imagine since like the Parthenon and every Greek temple was a little bit more colorful than as we see them today. So that's why the decorations on the pharos are a little bit different from what you would see in, well, every depiction of it, except if you're taking a Renaissance depiction of it, because then it would just be like, what the fuck is this place? So back to the artwork on the balcony, because I think I tried to talk about that 2 to 3 times now already, and it already took, well, at least 2 weird turns. So the artwork is kind of a mashup of 2 depictions, I would say, because in one depiction it had these like, not really, it didn't have any fencing or something, but it did have these weird round bulges, which you kind of see sometimes in other buildings as well, that there's just some like extensions. I don't know why, probably for a little bit of like, don't go to the edge, and also to, of course, make it pretty, because if you make a building in honor of someone, you have to make it pretty, otherwise it's just a huge insult, especially in those times, I think. So there are these weird round bulges, which in a way still look pretty, or at least I made them a little bit prettier, because again, when it's depicted in, well, what they think it looked like, it's a pretty bare building. There isn't a lot of decoration happening. There are like some statues which I did actually put in. Like, it is depicted always as having a statue on the uppermost roof, and there are statues on the corners of the balcony. So those are actually historically accurate. I didn't find the right statues, because on the uppermost roof it was actually supposed to be like a statue of, I think, Poseidon, which fits because it's a lighthouse, it's in the harbor, it's connected to the sea. But for the balcony there were this, I think, statues of some water gods or something, and I found these statues on the workshop from the Tree Maker's Toolkit, and you know, I just, they are pretty women, so I just said these might be water nymphs, and I just went with that, and it looks good, because even from down below, like from deep view as I would call it, you can still see all those statues. And I first thought to have like the uppermost statue or the roof statue, which is now like this winged angel with a torch. I thought to place that one on the place where the water nymphs are, but that statue is just way too big. So C went up there, the water nymphs are on the balcony, and then the balcony has these weird round bulges, which are a little bit of fencing, or I think they are meant to be pretty, but also a little bit meant to be functional as to warn you, like, this is the edge, don't go there. But in another depiction there was some, I don't know what to call it, it's a little bit more like fencing, but it's also clearly not, because it's really kind of like, maybe like it was iron fencing something. I even don't know if this balcony was actually accessible in ancient times, but I just assumed it was, because why have a balcony or something like that if you aren't going to be able to reach that place? Like, that's still one thing in like ancient Grecian architecture, I always look at it with a functional thing in mind. Like, if it doesn't have a clear function, if it's not meant to either be pretty or have a function, then it doesn't make any sense to be there. It shouldn't be there. It most of the times isn't there. Like, if it isn't used to be pretty or to have a function, I'm pretty certain that they wouldn't add it, because most of those temples are made of marble and all that really precious, really expensive stuff. So again, if it's not for decoration or for function, they wouldn't add it, because it would just be expensive for nothing. So that's why this balcony is accessible. That's why this balcony, I think the things are railings or fencing to, you know, it's a high place. You don't want people to go below the fast way. I don't know how I wanted to phrase that in a somewhat, well, not positive, but a somewhat nice way. But the fencing is a little bit weird, because it's meant to, I think, simulate waves. It's meant to, you know, have the curves of waves, which this, well, what was the name of it? This cake thingy, the frosting. For the first time, I finally get the words. But these frosting pieces look pretty good, and actually look pretty similar to what is depicted in what researchers think the building would have looked like. And I just messed the weird bulges and the wave structure, fencing, something together, and it actually looks pretty good. But it gives a little bit more of a pop of color. And before you ask, yes, those waves were blue. Yes, they were a little bit weird. But then, the fencing was meant to be functional, but also decorational, I think at least. So that's what's mostly for this balcony. The, well, the fencing part is the most decorated. The underneath, like, were, I'm just going to call it fresco area. I'm going to find a real name for it. That was actually pretty mild. Like, the fencing area was pretty abundant, pretty in your face, but the where you would expect like statues and all that, and you know, the things you see on like the roof of a temple, from what I see, it's pretty mild in that area when you talk about the pharaohs. And I did look at every little depiction of the pharaohs that I could find. Also, I quickly want to add, there are some, well, there are four, like, I would call them extensions to the main structure. And these are in some depictions, and in some depictions they aren't there, but I thought it would be a nice add. So that's why they're there. And that's going to be it for today. In the next video, we are going to detail the lower area or the base, and we are going to work a little bit already on the courtyard, planning things out, moving the entire pharaohs, because that's a shit show to do, because I didn't think this would have as many pieces as it has today, because it has over 10,000 pieces already now. So my thought was just, let's move it now before it gets even bigger, so that everything, if it's done, is in the right place, and I don't have to move this thing again. So again, that will be it for today. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it, and I hope, if you like it, to see you back in the next video, which will be probably tomorrow. See you soon. Bye-bye.